Hello trainers, Ganeto here, and today we're gonna dive into Hallen Cup and we're gonna watch together two teams that I think are gonna go super good, build around this the core of Sebelai and Azumarill. Before we do though, be sure to leave a like before you go in the end or leave a subscribe to my channel because it really helps grow my community over here a little bit more and share the word that we are absolutely doing videos about Pokemon Go. With that said, let's dive into the fights, and we're gonna fight the first trainer, Anifion here, who is an amazing trainer of the Pokemon Go Greek community, and here we are with our Sebelai up in front, and I love Sebelai up in front because you can go really good against anything. You can also counter hard those Ghost types, Jelly Sense, Alola Marowak, Honder, Gengar, whatever Kofagrygus that may appear, and you're still gonna have a good time. You can wall those Pokemon pretty well. You can absolutely wall down the Confusion users like Wormadam, Trash, and you're gonna have a good time against those Poison types. Golbat, you saw there that we could actually do a lot of work against it, so we're gonna take the win eventually. So we're just gonna both switch out to our Pokemon, and we're gonna get hit with a return on our Nidoqueen. That was harsh, but it's still okay since we can go in now with our Azumarill. And one thing that I love about Nidoqueen is that whatever you do, you are never actually on a lost position against anything because you have Poison Fang. Excuse me about that. Poison Fang will debuff your opponent, and you can see here that we can farm down with Azumarill, finish off, and now we have a lot of energy and shielding our Sebelai here, going for the double foul play to provoke the shield and do huge damage, despite the fact that we are hurt now from that bubble beam. Look at that, we are already there, and this will do a lot of damage though, so our Azumarill will come into the fight and finish off the job. You can see though that Nidoqueen takes a lot of damage. That is because it is a shadow. You can use always a non-shadow one. This is another fight with the same team against Awesome Zen this time, and you will see that he's leading off with Shadow Scizor. He loves that thing, I love that thing, I wish I could play with that thing, but I prefer my Sebelai in front and not Scizor. Despite the fact that I think that this is gonna be a very nice pick, because Alola Marowak will not be a thing for sure, and you're gonna have a good time with whatever, especially if you catch the buff with your Scizor. So yeah, really consider it. And if you want to see his videos, be sure to check him out in his channel. Link will be down in the description. So we're gonna fall to that Azumarill, and you saw how much damage that Ice Beam dealt. So I'm just gonna recommend to you using the regular Nidoqueen, so that you're gonna have a better time, I guess, against that Azumarill, and you're still gonna win because Poison Fang still is gonna do a lot of damage after the first one debuffs your opponent. So yeah, really consider that. Here comes my Ice Beam on that Scizor. Normally I would go for Hydro Pump, but it is a shadow, it is glassy, and it was low HP, so no reason at all to go for a Hydro. And they will bring out that Umbreon, so I'm just gonna take the moves here and rely on my backline. Nidoqueen is gone, so I have only Sebelai, and I love Sebelai because despite the fact that you can use it as a very good lead, you can use it as well as a closer. And look at that, everyone, we're just gonna get a lot of damage to our Azumarill, but it's still okay, and we're just gonna finish off here with Sebelai, and there you have it. This is the first team that I would like to showcase to you. I hope I did it with success. The team style is called Solid because I love how solid that team is. It's not high on it's not that high, I can say, on its attack stat. Yeah, let's call it like this. But you're gonna have a very good time because it is gonna be such a solid team, well around, all around, and you are not gonna have a lot of weaknesses. Anyways, next one, and we're gonna face against Awesome Zen with his favorite Pokemon so far in the Hallen Cup, the Shadow Scizor. And you are gonna see that in this one, we are leading off with Galvantula, keeping the core at the back, Sebelai and Azumarill. So here comes my discharge. Perhaps I should have gone here for the launch. I was expecting a shield to be honest, but they had one less, so I was like, perhaps they don't shield. And yeah. Galvantula is gonna be super good for us because like Sebelai is gonna have a very good amount of leads, and on top of that, you can go for the debuff with your launch and do a lot of damage to your opponent, and if they shield, you can do the debuff so your backline can have a better time. You're not afraid of a lot of things. Even against Alola Marowak, you still have some play with discharge, you can do some damage and then farm down with Azumarill, so it's never lost. And yeah, you can lose it out, why not? Here comes my Ice Beam, down goes the Scizor, and you can see that the Galvantula against the Scizor is gonna have a very good win scenario. So here comes the Azu, I decide to take the move, I don't care at all. Here comes the Playraf, I don't run Playraf on my Azumarill because I want to have Hydro Pump for those Drapions, for those Alola Max. You know what I mean, you cannot threat those Pokemon enough with your Playraf. You need a closing move, I guess, because I do not shield my Azu. I always go for the hyper move whenever I can, so gonna do a lot of damage and then keep my shields for my Galvantula. And if the Hydro Pump lands, it's all good, yeah, why not? And more damage for me, and then the Volt Switch are gonna do a lot of damage, and the Shadow Claw from the Sableye will be enough. Both Sableye and Azumarill are gonna be some really cool safe options for you. So if you encounter, I don't know, something like a Swampert, but Swampert is not viable, you can still go ahead and go out of the field with your Azu or your Sableye. Against Mawile, I prefer to bring my Azumarill if I can, but if, I repeat, if I encounter the Mawile up in front and not as a switching, I will go for the Sableye because I want to keep my Azumarill for the Mawile, because if they had the Mawile up in the lead, they will switch it out as soon as they see my switched in Azumarill. Get it? Okay, I hope you did. So here comes my launch, and let's see how well that can do against that Jellicent. Not much. I was hoping that I can get the shield, to be honest, but that did not happen. Awesome Zen knows better. So here comes Shadow Ball. Oh, that's not Awesome Zen. That's Anifen. Okay, and here comes my launch. This is gonna do a lot of damage and most probably gonna finish it off. So yeah, down goes the Jellicent, and at the last. As the last Pokemon, there is gonna be a Golbat, really good for us, and we're just gonna bait them now with the launch. You can see how good that Galvantula is in the meta. I really love it. A lot of work, a lot of debuffs, a lot of shield pressure, and you can still take the moves. There is no reason at all to shield every single one. It is glassy, I know, but not that glassy. You can take moves like Poison Fang, like Acid Spray. You can take moves like the resisted ones, Cross Chops, or the counter damage from the fast attack, so you're gonna have a good time. Overall, I believe that this Sableye Azumarill core is gonna go huge for the Halloween Cup, so be sure to check it out, and if you want to check more videos, be sure to check out right up here in the corner my video about the previous Halloween Cup teams around Sableye. Leave a subscribe, leave a like if you enjoy videos like this. It gives me the courage to continue and do more content like this for Pokemon Go. I also go some Pokemon Unite, so give that some love as well, and I hope to see you all into the next one. Thank you for watching, trainers. Stay safe.